Hi there, welcome to Guitar Interactive. This is Giorgio Serci, and in this lesson I'd like to share with you a composition of mine called Lullaby. It's very short, and as I normally do, I'll play it in its entirety, and then we're going to look at each bar in detail. Enjoy it. Try not to fall asleep, of course. So there was a short composition of mine called Lullaby, and let's look at each bar in detail. So to start with, we have an intro, and I'm playing a natural harmonic E on the 12th fret of E, and then this lovely chord featuring E, F sharp, and D sharp on the 9th fret of G, 7th fret of B, and 11th fret of E. And then while the low E is still ringing, I also play the following chord, which features C sharp, D sharp, and B. So. And the next chord, I really like this chord, it's quite dark in a way. It's a B13 flat 9. As you can see, I'm using a barre or bar chord on the 7th fret. And then we have a little finger on fret 10 of D, middle finger on fret 8 of G, and ring finger on fret 9 of B. Expensive chord. The next chord features G sharp on the 6th fret of D, then C sharp on the 6th fret of G, and D sharp on the 4th fret of B. Which you could describe as an E major 13. So that's the intro. And then the melody starts with B on the 7th fret of E. And then we play A as well together, open A. And then the 6th fret of D, 6th fret of G, and open B. So. And then fret 5 of E, open A again. And then fret 4 of D, fret 5 of G, and open B. So. Next is going to be an E major 6, And as you can see, I'm using a similar shape from the previous one. We have a little finger on fret 4 of E, ring finger on fret 4 of G, and then index on fret 2 of E, and also B. And the same part again. I do enjoy playing this tune quite fluidly. So sometimes I might play the melody on the downbeat, and some other times on the upbeat. So I might do. So on the downbeat or on the upbeat. Next part, we hold the same shape with the left hand, but we're playing a different chord. So earlier we were playing that shape over an E bass, implying E6. But next, we're going to use the same shape over an A. So what chord do we imply with this shape? That would be that's a major 7, and that's the 9. So we call that an A major 9. Next, as you can see, I've got my little finger on fret 2 of E, middle finger on fret 2 of D, ring finger on fret 2 of G, and then the index is playing C. So that's a non-diatonic note, which means it's a note not in the key. The key of this tune is E major, so that's not really in the key, and it creates a little bit of tension, which I like. So you've got this color. Yeah. So the name of this chord is A minor 6. And then the melody will be an open B and just an arpeggio around an E add 9 chord. Again, the last part. Okay, so this section twice. So we play the same part again. Feel free to, as I said earlier on, to play the melody in a quite free way from a rhythmic standpoint. So you can play it on the beat or up on the upbeat. Off bit, and again. And then there is a B section, which is quite similar to start with. We start with the same chord, namely A major 9, and then the melody is the same as before, but the chord is different. As you can see, I'm playing this shape, which features the middle finger on fret 5 of A, index on fret 4 of D, ring finger on fret 5 of G, and open B. So the name of this chord is D 13. So it's a D7 with the added 6. So, and I do enjoy keeping that open B ring. It gives kind of gives the tune a more legato, I guess, quality. And then the next chord, that is like a C sharp minor 7, but with a passing chord. Da, da. That's a flat 6 resolving into the 5th. Yeah. And then the next chord, I play the melody, which is F sharp, fret 2 of E, and then I arpeggiate this nice open C add 9 chord. Yeah. So from the previous bar. And then open B. Followed by this chord, which is an F sharp minor 11, which features the middle finger on fret 2 of E, ring finger on fret 2 of D, little finger on fret 2 of G, and an open B again. And then this. So index on fret 2, open B. So fret 2 of B, open B. And then fret 3 of G, and open B. When you do this, it's preferable to mute your string. So instead of keeping your, because it gets a bit messy that way, it gets a little bit cluttered. So, and then this chord can be described in many different ways. You can call this an A major 7 over B or a B 13 sus 4. But it's quite easy to play because we're using an index finger on the second fret, just like a bar chord, with the little finger on fret 4 of E. And then we can lift the little finger and play the F sharp. And then back to an E add 9. So the second, well, the B section again. First time, instead of playing actually E add 9, I think I played an E dominant 7. So, the kind of classic E dominant 7 E shape. And then we play the same part again. To finish with, we play the same chords and harmonics that we played in the intro. Sometimes you might want to play the root, the tonic, down an octave as well. So that is the mini composition for you, very short, nice and sweet, and hopefully you'll it will be an opportunity for you to try different chords, like the D13 with an open B, which I think is quite nice, and that chord as well, the A minor 6 is quite nice, followed by the lovely E add 9, which is quite common. It's a bit of a cliche, but I think it always works. It works quite well, particularly on a nylon string guitar. As always, try to use some of these ingredients to create your own recipes, so to speak. So create your own compositions, and maybe writing stuff down can be useful whenever you're creating your own composition. So I always try to demonstrate mainly some ideas that you could use to create your own tunes, your own compositions. So I hope you find this useful, and until next time, goodbye.